गुड मॉर्निंग. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू रूल नंबर 8. कंट्रोल कैन नॉट बी ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम अ स्टेटमेंट आउटसाइड द डू लूप टू अ स्टेटमेंट इनसाइड द डू लूप. लेट अस सी व्हाट इज रूल नंबर 9. Rule number 9. What is rule number 9? Control cannot be transferred from a statement inside the do loop or within the do loop to the do statement itself. Let us write example for this. Find line number of this statement do 10, line number of last statement, running variable I, initial value 1, final value 10, increment 2, other statements and then this statement. Go to 5. What is 5? It is line number of do loop, statement number of this do statement. This is not allowed according to rule number 9. Control cannot be transferred from a statement inside or within the do loop to the do statement itself. If we construct the loop this way, it will be invalid loop. It will not be executed. Error will occur in the loop. Okay, this is according to rule number 9. Then come to rule number 10. Control can be transferred from a statement inside the do loop to a statement outside the do loop. Rule number 10. Control can be transferred from a statement inside or within the do loop to a statement outside the do loop. The example may be statement number 2, sum is equal to sum into I. It can be any statement. It is outside the do loop. Statement number of do loop is 5. Okay. This is a statement inside the do loop. And what is this? It is control statement which transfers the control. Go to 2. When the control from do loop comes here, this statement sends the control to statement number 2. One example. Other example may be. Do loop, statement within do loop. After execution of these statements, control is transferred to line number 20. Where is line number 20? Line number 20. Here, there will be some statement. Here I have written one statement, sum is equal to sum into I. Depending on the task, some statement may be here. In first example, what we find, control from a statement inside the do loop is sent to a statement outside the do loop. What we find here, control from a statement inside the do loop or within the do loop is transferred to a statement outside the do loop. This is valid. These two are valid do loop constructions according to rule number 10. And what is that? Control can be transferred from a statement within the do loop or inside the do loop to a statement outside the do loop. This is rule number 10. Now let us go to rule number 11. Rule number 11. Last statement of a do loop should not be a control statement like if statement, if arithmetic statement, if logical statement, if then else statement, nested if statement. or go to statement or other do loop. If last statement of the do loop is a control statement, that do loop will be invalid. The control statement may be arithmetic if statement, it may be logical if statement, it may be if then else statement, it may be nested if then else statement, it may be go to statement, or it may be other do loop. This is not allowed while constructing the do loop. These are the 11 rules. This is the third lecture. We are talking about the rules of do loop. This is the 11th rule of do loop. These rules should be obeyed while constructing the do loop. When these rules are obeyed by any do loop constructed by you, that do loop will be executed without any error, and the task for which the do loop is constructed will be completed without any error. So, this is about the rules of do loop. After having known the rules of do loop, the next article is next article from this chapter is the continue statement. Next article from this chapter is the continue statement. This statement is a dummy statement. Continue statement is a dummy statement. It is used as last statement. It is used as last statement of do loop. You know rule number 9. You know rule number 11 of do loops. What is rule number 9? The control from a statement within the do loop or inside the do loop should not be transferred to the do statement itself. What is rule number 11? Last statement of the do loop should not be itself a control statement like arithmetic if, logical if, if then else, nested if then else, go to, or other do statement itself. When we use continue statement, rule number 9 and 11 will be, rule number 9 and 11 will be violated. Let us see how rule numbers 9 and 11 are violated when continue statement is used as the last statement or dummy statement in the do loop itself. Let me write some example of do loop without using continue statement. Do 10 I is equal to 2, 14, 2, Let us go through this example. Do 10, line number of last statement of do loop, I is equal to initial value 2, final value 14, this 2 is the increment. Sum is equal to I plus 2, go to 5, after that write asterisk comma 2 sum. What will happen? After execution of this statement and this statement, control will go to 5. This is invalid because this write asterisk comma 2 sum statement will not be executed. Without execution of the whole loop, the control is sent to the do loop from a statement inside the do loop, and therefore this is invalid execution of the do loop. Let us make this valid. Now come to the example. We have seen that this is invalid example. Now come to this one. 5 statement number of the do statement of do loop, 10 line number of last statement of do loop, I running variable, 2 initial value, 14 final value, this 2 is increment. Here sum is defined different than this. Here sum is defined as I plus 2. Here I have used some other expression, sum is equal to I to the power I. Go to 10, last statement. What is continue? And what does this continue? It is dummy statement, last statement of do loop. It sends the control to do loop and execution of do loop will be continued till this I reaches to 14, and therefore this is valid. The control is sent, the control is transferred from a statement inside the do loop to the do statement itself. It is made valid by the continue statement, which we use as dummy statement or last statement of the do loop. So this example is valid example, this is invalid example. Let me have one small program. Let me construct a small program to represent that this type of construction of do loop is valid. This is very simple program. Let us see how this program is valid. Loop is do 10 line number of last statement, running variable I, initial value 1, final value 100, increment 2. Read, remember this is unformatted input statement. This is unformatted output statement. This statement is unformatted input statement. This statement is unformatted output statement. While completing the earlier chapter, the earlier unit, I told you that this is the read statement which is unformatted. This is the output statement which is unformatted. With the use of these input statement and output statement, let me show how this example is valid. Okay, read n. Read n, you can input any value. Of course, it will be integer. Right? Then, that value n is compared with 40. If n is greater than 40, it is not to be printed, it is not to be given to the output, because if n is greater than 40, this statement sends control to the last statement of do loop, go to 10. It is skipped. Print n is skipped. It is run how many times? 50 times. It, because of this loop, initial value 1, final value 100, you are allowed to increase this value by 2 each time. Okay. So, the loop will be performed, the loop will be repeated. How many times? 50 number of times the loop will be repeated, and you can read the value from the input. Actually, the user is allowed to input the value to the read statement from the keyboard. How many times? 50 times. Each time this n is compared with 40. If whenever this n is more than 40, that value will be skipped, that value will not be printed, that value will not be sent to the output. If this value is smaller than 40, then it will be printed. If it is more than 40, just the value is skipped, the value is just skipped, control sent to the last statement of do loop, continue. Control sent to do statement, this will be continued. So this is a small program explaining how this continue statement is used as the last statement or dummy statement. This is about the continue statement in Fortran. Hope you got it with this example. Actually, we can go for many more examples, but it is sufficient here. Thank you.